Okay, so then next question, guys. It says that a by b is equal to twice of root 2 plus root 10 divided by 5 into root 3 plus root 5. Sorry, under root whole of 3 plus root 5. Okay, so it's under root whole of 3 plus root 5. Okay, now we need to find the value of a plus b here. So what is the value of a plus b? Knowing that A and B are relatively prime with each other. So relatively prime means there should be co-prime actually. Okay, so what is the value of A plus B? What is the question, guys? So A by B equal to twice of under root 2 plus under root 10 divided by under root 5 as divided by 5 into under root whole 3 plus root 5. Okay, let me write it again. So it should be more clear, right? Under root 3 plus root 5. Yes. Yes. So now if you observe this question, okay. So again, a very good question, very good algebra question, right? See, if you observe this question basically, so what I should understand here is 3 plus root 5. Okay, this value is actually 3 plus root 5. So I want to somehow factorize it so that this 3 plus root 5 is cancelled from denominator. Hai na? Obviously, I want to factorize something like that. 3 plus root 5 is cancelled from denominator. So you can rationalize it, right? Or if you rationalize it, rather than you can observe it also, that 3 plus root 5, can observe this, that 3 plus root 5 or in, sorry, in and in 3 minus root 5. So 3 plus root 5 into 3 minus root 5 is equal to 3 square minus root 5 square, that is equal to 4. Okay, so this value is coming as 4 here. Fine. That means, and what is how you get this 4 actually? This 4 can be under root 4, you can put here. So here I can put under root 4, right? So there's observation if you can do here, so it'll become a lot easier, right? So what I can do, like for example, so let's say a by b value is given, and this 2 can be written as root 4. Okay, and what is this 4? This 4 is 3 plus root 5 into 3 minus root 5. So can I write this root 4 as basically? Can I write this root 4 as instead of 2, root 4, and that root 4 can be as what? 3 plus root 5 into 3 minus root 5. Okay, and now it can go as further, right? That is root 2 plus root 10 and then divided by 5 into root of 3 plus root 5. Correct? Okay, now further here, if I break this, right? So actually, I can just cancel this part now. Okay, so this part I can just cancel and I can just write this value as this. Actually, you can just break it like this. A by b is equal to under root. Now you can just, sorry, you can just write like this here. So this will be actually be like 3 plus root 5 under root 3 minus root 5 under root. Correct. Now into root 2 plus root 10. Okay, and then 5 of 5 into under root 3 plus root 5. So you can just cancel out this value here. Okay, and then we have 3 minus root 2, 3 minus root 5 into root 2 we have, and this root 2 again I can take common as here, guys. So a by b will be equal to what? 3 minus root 5. Okay, and then root 2 I can take as common here. So it will become like if I take root 2 common, root 5 plus 1. Correct. Divided by 5. Now, if you can further solve it, this becomes actually a by b is equal to, now this 3 minus root 5 into root 2 can be written as 3, sorry, one root I missed, no? Yes. Okay, so 3 minus root 5 into root 2, that becomes what? That becomes 6 minus 2 root 5. It's whole under root, okay, and then into root 5 plus 1. Okay, so divide by, now divide by 5 actually, right? And now if you observe that, why did I do this? Because 6 minus 2 root 5. If you know how to factorize it, right? So basically 6 minus 2 root 5. Okay. So it actually, you should know this. Okay. So actually, you should know this, that if it is 6 minus 2 root 5 here, okay. Then that actually becomes 6 minus 2 root 5 here. then it actually becomes 6 minus 2 root 5. Yeah. So say 6 minus 2 root 5 will be equal to what? Will be equal to you can just break like this here, a square plus b square minus 2ab form. So a is root 5 and b is something like 1 here. So I can quickly write this value as root 5 minus 1 whole square. Okay. So you can just write as a is root 2, b is 1. So basically a is root, not sorry, root 5 and b is 1. So root 5 and 1 here. Okay, root 5 and 1. So I can quickly write this value as what? Root 5 minus 1 whole square. Once I write this value as root 5 minus 1 whole square. Okay. So now a by b. A by b will be equal to root 5 minus 1 whole square. It's under root into root 5 plus 1. Okay. Now divided by 5. And this actually becomes root 5 minus 1 into root 5 plus 1 divided by 5. This actually becomes what? 4 by. This is, so this should be a minus b into a plus b, this should be 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 should be the answer of this question, right? So once again, a fantastic question, a very good question. The key idea behind this question was basically I need to break this and whole under root. Okay. So first I wrote like 3 minus root 5, then I multiplied this root 2 to make it in the form of what? A square plus b square minus 2ab, and then that automatically comes out to be root 5 minus 1 whole square. That is actually this one, 4 by 5 should be the answer. Also, all of you must give this combat, guys. So it's a really good exam happening every Sunday at 12 p.m. So in this you get a really good quality questions with the questions which are a kind of new. You won't find those on other platforms. Okay. So it gives a good experience, very close to CAT, because the quality of the questions will be of that level and that will be new for all of you. Also, it's a fun because it will be all India leaderboard. Okay, after every question, so you can, the faster you answer a question, the better score will be after every question that leaderboard shows, right? It's a kind of fun also. So do this, give, it's a good exercise, 1 hour every Sunday, make it a habit. And whatever questions are there, just make a note of those questions, because those are your question bank, and it'll be it, every week we are doing it right now. So already I think 6 or 7 combats are over. So there's some good high quality questions, 10 questions in 10 questions per combat in quant, 10 questions per combat in LRDI. So you already have some 60-70 good questions collection, okay, in quant and LRDI, and same for verbal also, right? So do give it, guys, Sunday 12 p.m. Okay, it invite code, it will ask you, put the invite code Ravi Rodha. So Ravi Rodha, it will be invite code. Okay, it is absolutely free for everyone. You just download an Academy app and register for combat. Okay.